BBC Radio Suffolk. Each evening we end the show with a final thought, a chance to talk about how you feel and share that with Suffolk along with a piece of music. Bob Crowley is providing our final thoughts this week. He's dealing with the loss of his life, who passed away last year. We're going to find out more about Julie McCready, Bob's partner for 30 years. Julie became the UK's youngest female newspaper editor. She was editor of the East Anglian Daily Times, also the first woman to work on the floor of the London Stock Exchange, and was city editor for a leading national newspaper. Now, of course, Julie's loss has knocked Bob sideways, and that is evident in this interview, and, of course, completely understandable.
She had an amazing career. She actually started off not in a very good way. She had terrible eyesight or eye problems, and she was in hospital for a long, long time as a child. And then she had polio, and she was not forced but encouraged to ballet dance, which she did successfully, to strengthen her legs and her, I suppose, give her confidence in the end. And she was a very confident person.
So when did you meet her?
I met her in 1987. I was just travelling up, newly started to work in London, and I travelled on the Ipswich to Liverpool Street train in the buffet car, because that was nice and friendly. It was the old-fashioned sort. And she knew me. I knew her by sight, but not to speak to. And then I think I was on my own then, and we went with a group of other people to see a pantomime in London, Victoria. Nothing else happened. We still continued to commute on the train. And then in 1988, in February, it was a leap year, she proposed to me on the train. I said, no, I'm not having any of that. I don't know why. But a couple of days later, I phoned her and said, look, if we're going to get married, we ought to have dinner. And that's what we did. And very shortly after, we lived together. It was lovely. But one of the very first dates we ever had was, I was reading out the other day with somebody else, was a place called Rishu in Piccadilly. Very trendy cafe, I suppose you'd call it. Mm. We had some good places to go to. But both my daughters live in Devon, and we used to commute up and down, or not commute, visit them up and down for 30 years, but basically all the time I knew Julie. I now live in Bubby Tracy, which is on the edge of Dartmoor. And it was our plan, when Julie was becoming unwell, to move nearer my daughters, one of whom is a nurse, just to be closer to them and have better family relationship. So when we moved down, unfortunately, it was with when Julie went straight into care. So we continued with the thoughts to go into Devon. But she went into a care home that was actually supervised by my youngest daughter, say, who runs a community nursing team. So she was able to see her two or three times a week, which was really nice.
And you've kind of alluded to the fact that Julie is having health problems. So what health problems was she having?
Well, about 2009 to 2011, it's difficult to put your finger on it, but her mental capacity, she just kept repeating things. And initially, I just used to say, well, you've told me that, and it was cruel to say that, but only afterwards do you realise that it's an increasing problem, that she was on the road to dementia. And it was not until 2015, she was actually diagnosed with vascular dementia, which is caused by a stroke. And there were several things that I suppose could have caused the stroke. The death of her son was significant in her life, obviously. Her mum and dad, they were very close family, very close. They died relatively close together. So all those were traumatic events in her own life. And we used to have a place in London which we lived in Monday to Friday, and sometimes in the evening in London, because it's a busy, bustling place, she'd go very aggressive with people if they, totally unlike her, but if they crossed her, if you like, not as physically crossed her, but if they crossed her path or bumped into her or things like that, she would get a bit ratty, which was just not her at all. So after 2015, things began to get worse. I mean, everything falls apart in your life, or the person with the illness's life. Their physical attributes fail them. Can't get out properly, can't dress properly, can't wash properly, can't clean your teeth properly. Cooking was just a non-event. Still love to see people, but it, obviously in a slightly different circumstances. And then in about 2018, I said to her, look, I really like to walk with you, and would you mind if we got a wheelchair? So she was happy with that, because we lived on at Clacton then, and walking along the seafront there is very pleasant in the summer. And then it just said, then at home, you know, difficulty switching lights on and off. And she'd go in, I painted the light switches a purple colour so she could recognise them. But then I'd find that she'd come back and just check up everything was okay, and she'd find she tried to switch the lights off by turning on the shower. It was just awful. It's not a very pleasant illness, and specifically for the person who's got it. But equally, and that's what I've done the CD for, is for carers, because carers need care. And they also need to be able to give comfort and compassion.
And that's what your website is called, carecomfortcompassion.org. You've got a CD with music, and it's listed. You can hear it on your website. It's got tracks on it. They're not all music tracks. There's tell me more about what's on the CD.
Well, I have the first track is called Amor, which is written by a guy called Jose Marti. I've only used a part of the poem, but it's where I found it when Julie first went into hospital, and it was very apt. And later I wrote a couple more lines myself to go with it, which is also on the CD. There's also a poem written by Owen Darnell, who's an American, and he wrote it with his wife, through his wife's mind, and it's very moving. I have The Wind Beneath My Wings, which is a song from Beaches, which both Julie and I loved. There's a couple of songs from a River Song harmony group, which I sing with. There's also a couple of classical guitar pieces from a friend of mine in Devon. There's a couple of tracks from a Spooky Men's Chorale, who are Australian harmony group, wonderful to watch, odd to watch. They're all different shapes and sizes, and scruffy, if I'm honest, but just great sound. There's a couple of songs by my daughter, who sings sort of semi-professionally. And there's a song by Annie Lennox called Into the West, which is very moving. The Parting Glass, which is by an Irishman called Malachi Cush, which is lovely. We both used to like a drink in the evening. And then there's also verse 2154 from the Quaker Faith and Practice. I'm a Quaker, and when we got married, we actually had a Quaker wedding, with also Church of England, Muslim and Jewish blessings, because we were quite widely travelled and had lots of different friends. And then the last item is called Lusty Bells. I do church bell ringing down here in several churches. This isn't one that I rang on, but I do ring at Lusty Church. So it's a real mix, eclectic mix of music. And I've said, I think it pays to listen to it all rather than pick it out, because I find it very calming.
And you hope others in a similar situation would find it calming as well?
I produced it specifically for carers. And I think at this moment in time, a lot of carers of a lot of people with different illnesses would benefit from it. The beneficiaries of it all will be the Alzheimer's Society, because that's what I'm seeking early early diagnosis, because I think that would help people, help carers particularly, to help them care for their loved ones.
So you can donate. Can you get a physical CD that way?
You can get a physical CD. I mean, I have them. They're a limited edition, which is because you don't need so much permission to get a limited edition number or permission. And I've got some. I've had those, but I'm just about to get some more runoff, depending on what the take up is. But the download is any amount of numbers and any amount of value. But as a minimum, I'll put on it £10. But you can, don't be shy, put them all in if you want to.
She was editor of the EADT, wasn't she?
She was indeed, East Anglian Daily Times and 8 other local newspapers. She started off the Junior Blues for Ipswich Football Club. Our wedding cake was green. And we had several people, Man United, Leicester City supporters, our friends. So when we had the cake, we put on it Man U 2, Ipswich 6, or Leicester 4, Ipswich 5, just to wind them up, and it really did. And that was the, I think it, we got married in 2000, and that was the year Ipswich went up. So that was timely.
It sounds like you're still suffering with grief. Does it get any easier?
It does get easier. But it comes and goes.
Yeah, of course it does. And that's fine. Absolutely fine.
One of the things I'm finding difficult at the moment is getting out and doing the things we said we'd do.
Yeah. Well, you got to try and do it, mate. You got to try and...
I do.
Okay.
Yes, it does get easier, that is for sure.
Okay.
But not quickly.
That's Bob. He's created that CD called Care, Comfort and Compassion. Find out more on the website carecomfortandcompassion.org. It includes music and poetry that has brought comfort to Bob in his loss, and we'll meet Bob again towards the end of the show. A final thought coming up in a couple of minutes' time, and this week it's from Bob Crowley. He's created a special CD in memory of his wife of 30 years, Julie McCready. She was editor of the East Anglian Daily Times during her time, plus many, many other things. We heard, I had a chat with him earlier on this evening. So we'll catch up with his final thoughts. Final thought comes from Bob Crowley. He's created a special CD to help himself with the loss of his partner of 30 years, Julie McCready. And in the process, he hopes it will help others that are dealing with loss. You can find out more about the CD. CareComfortCompassion.org is the place to go, and you can listen to the CD in its entirety. Bob is doing our final thought all this week, and let's start.
After Julie died, I intended to do something in her memory. I joined a Natural Voice Harmony group to help me socialise. One evening, a song we had been rehearsing was posted on our WhatsApp group, and I thought it sounded pretty good. It put the idea in my mind to produce a CD and a download for carers specifically. Caring can be very difficult and lonely at times, and becomes increasingly so. Pressure to administer medicine, personal care, dress, feed, entertain, and take out, etc. None of which is a problem, but it becomes 24 hours a day, every day. Early diagnosis research is, to my mind, essential, and recently the Alzheimer's Society has suffered a reduction in funds due to COVID. So all proceeds from these sales will go to Alzheimer's Society. My selection for inclusion was all related to providing a caring, comforting and compassionate sound. The first two part tracks are firstly from a poem by Jose Marte and describes my feelings when Julie was taken into the hospital and left our quirky house for the last time. The look of fear and concern on her face was awful. Love is born with the pleasure of looking at each other. It is fed with the necessity of seeing each other. It is concluded with the impossibility of separation. The second poem, read in full by a friend of mine, as it was not something I could do, was written by Owen Darnell in the mind of his wife, who died of dementia. It is very moving, and one which I wish I had been introduced to when Julie started to become unwell. However, I like to think it helped me through the last months to care for her in a better, more understanding way, and to have more cuddles to care for, and to kiss her cheek and hold her hand.
Do not ask me to remember. Don't try to make me understand. Let me rest and know you're with me. Kiss my cheek and hold my hand. I'm confused beyond your concept. I'm sad and sick and lost. All I know is that I need you to be with me at all cost. Do not lose your patience with me. Do not scold or curse or cry. I can't help the way I'm acting. I can't be different, though I try. Just remember that I need you, that the best of me is gone. Please don't fail to stand beside me. Love me till my life is gone.
The musical track for the evening is The Wind Beneath My Wings, written by Jeff Silbar, who gave me permission to use it, saying, "Go for it." And is from the film Beaches. We saw it together in Leicester Square and came out blubbering. In our time together, for the first 20 years, we were equal partners. Where possible, I would follow Julie to her work abroad in some wonderful developing countries, and she would visit projects I worked on and socialise with the teams. So much so that one of the people who employed me said they did not realise they got two when they employed me. This track inspires me to continue doing the things we set out to do together.